Hello everyone, we are from Team Mary Marigold and we are from Malaysia. The climate of our home resembles the tropical biomes in the Farmcraft challenge. At Malaysia, tractors are used for plowing, tilling and planting fields, spreading fertilizer and harvesting. Compared to farming in Farmcraft, most of the farming processes are handled without tractor except in the harvesting stage. Besides, in Farmcraft the farming process could be done continuously day and night, whereas in Malaysia, farmers do not stand at the farm 24 hours a day. For this week's challenge, we decided to complete the island biome and temperate biome challenges. After completing these two biomes challenges, we found out that we need to balance all farming factors, from soil quality, weed and insects invasion, water retention in order to gain higher score. Hence, we decided not to purchase any genetically engineered seeds. For island biome challenge, on our first attempt, we decided to concentrate on killing the caterpillars, and at the same time, monitor the soil quality. So my sister was assigned to spraying the fertilizer and water, whenever the soil quality or water level dropped to certain level. While I was in charge of killing the caterpillars. It ended up I couldn't kill the caterpillars on time and some crops were eaten by the caterpillars, resulting in low harvest score. So on our second attempt, we decided that each member in charge of taking care one row of the crops, hoping that we could kill the caterpillars before they eat our crops. This second method resulting in a slightly higher score than the first method, but sometimes we will have some argument who should spray the fertilizer or buy the bug removers. Then we tried for third time and my sister suggested that she will taking care of soil quality while I need to help her monitor her row of crops when she went to purchase either fertilizer or bug removers. So we tried play using method 3 and managed to get the highest score out of these three methods. While for temperate biome, on our first attempt, we decided to buy herbicide resistance seeds which cost us 150 coins. But we found out that this was not a good method as it ended up with lower coin balance and we did not have enough coins to purchase other resources like water or fertilizer at latter stages, resulting in lower total score. On our second attempt, we decided to manually taking care of the weeds and caterpillars. At the same time, my sister was assigned to monitor the soil quality while I was in charge of monitoring the water level. Each of us taking care one row of crops. The second method resulting in higher total score and we had learned that we need to play the game multiple times to find the best strategic method for each biome. On both biomes, our team experienced the challenge to kill the caterpillars on time, before the crops were eaten by them. We face this limitation due to lack of manpowers as our team only consists of myself and my sister. Besides, we need to continuously do the weeding, catching butterflies and killing caterpillars, watering, spraying fertilizer or herbicide or insecticide throughout the 8 stages, even during nighttime in order to obtain higher score.